This video discusses advanced placement credit and college credit taken in high school and the orientation data form. The orientation data form provides us information on advanced placement exam scores and dual college credits. We do not know about what AP and college classes you've taken unless thoroughly completing this form. So let's talk about the AP credit chart. Taurus.buffalo.edu shows AP credit as well as how college classes transfer in, which we'll go over soon. To get to the AP credit chart, head to Taurus.buffalo.edu. Click on the Alternative Exam Credit link. There's an AP chart you can access here. You can also Google UB AP chart. As an example, if you took Language and Composition AP and received a 4 or 5, that's equivalent to our English 105. You'd therefore not have to take that introductory composition course at UB, or how a 5 in Computer Science A is equal to our introductory computer science class. And here's Calculus AB, where receiving a 4 or 5 is equal to our Calculus 1, which is Math 141, the first calculus course taken by engineering students and computer science BS students. As far as registration, based on your high school transcripts and completing the data form, an academic advisor will register you into classes. You can view your schedule in the Hub Student Center. As far as a timeline, let's say we register you in June. Let's say you've taken AB Calculus and not receiving your score until July. That class is equivalent to Calculus 1. If you get your score in July and receive a 4 or 5 and wish to be placed into Calculus 2, you can update us via an online form called the Schedule Change Request Form. You may also have to take some important steps to finalize your schedule, such as completing our online math assessment called Alex, selecting pathways, and possibly enrolling in another class. Pay attention to emails received by us regarding those important steps, including a link to the Schedule Change Request form. You can also decline AP credit. So if you receive a 4 or 5 in AB Calculus and wanted to still take Calculus 1 anyway, you can decline the AP credit by completing a form. Actually, it's encouraged to consider declining AP credit for AB Calculus, as launching directly into Calculus 2, even with having scored a 4 or 5 in the AP exam, can be challenging, and having a very strong and confident foundation in introductory calculus is essential for all the additional math and related classes to come. If you choose to take a UB class equal to AP credit, completing the declination form is often important for financial aid reasons, so it's not considered a repeated class. Here is what the form looks like. You can also decline college transfer credit taken while in high school using the same declination form. If you have questions about any of this or what the best options are for you, please speak with your academic advisor. Also, AP credit in liberal arts areas can be used towards the UB curriculum pathways. For example, a 4 or 5 in psychology can be chosen in your pathways, or a 4 or 5 in US history satisfies the diversity requirement. Last but not least, be sure to send your AP credit to University at Buffalo. Our school code is 2925, and you can always find more information if you Google UBAP credit, since we have a website that explains that in depth. As far as how college credit applies, it might equal to a class here. We would head back to taurus.buffalo.edu to see how classes articulate. We'd click on this first link, search equivalency by school, then search by school, and type in the name of the college. And for this example, I'll put in Erie Community College. Let's say you took MT-181 at ECC. That class is equal to our Math 141. So put MT-181 on the data form. When you complete the orientation data form, it is important to provide the information requested, including college or university granting credit, their course number and title, year taken, and grade if already known. This will prevent you from being enrolled in courses you don't need to take because college credit you will already have. So in this video, we discussed the importance of inputting things for the orientation data form, AP credit, and college class credit, and considering the possibility of declining AP credit. Learning more about how to report your AP and college credit on your data form, and how this credit might be utilized as you enter UB, is an important first step in your transition to college. Thanks for watching, and be sure to check out the other videos in this playlist.